Hey, what's up everybody, and welcome to this tutorial series on Jenkins. My name is Moss, and I'm an experienced DevOps engineer with 6+ years of experience in the DevOps industry. Now that you know who I am, let's go ahead and take a look at the roadmap of topics that we're going to cover in this series. We'll start off with the basics and then progressively get into more advanced topics related to Jenkins. And in our first topic, we're going to answer the question, what is Jenkins? After we have a high-level understanding of Jenkins, we'll then install and configure Jenkins on our local machine. Once we've done that, we'll then install and configure the Maven plugin. And after we install the Maven plugin, we'll then learn how to integrate Jenkins and GitHub. I'll then show you how to schedule Jenkins builds using build triggers. Once you learn how to schedule builds, I'll then walk you through the creation of a Jenkins job for a Maven project. I'll then walk you through the configuration of a Jenkins controller and Jenkins agent nodes to facilitate distributed builds. This will lead us to an introduction of Jenkins pipelines. And we'll create our very own pipeline in our Jenkins instance. And finally, we'll add automated cross-browser testing into our Jenkins pipeline using LambdaTest. Now that you know what we're going to cover in this series, let's get started with the first topic. What is Jenkins? Jenkins is an open source automation server, and we use Jenkins to automate certain steps in the software development process. Jenkins helps software teams facilitate continuous integration and continuous deployment or delivery. In addition, Jenkins is a highly extensible tool. There are hundreds of plugins for Jenkins, and these plugins add functionality to Jenkins, or they enable Jenkins to integrate with other tools of the software development process. But why do we need Jenkins? What problem is Jenkins solving in the software development lifecycle? To understand this, let's take a look at a couple of key objectives for developers. The first objective is that developers who are working in parallel want to make sure that the features that they're developing integrate into the latest version of the codebase without errors. Without Jenkins, manual integration of changes happens infrequently. And because manual integration doesn't happen frequently, there's often a large backlog of changes pending to be merged. And this causes the manual integration process to be time-consuming, and we often refer to it as integration hell. The second objective is that developers also want to make sure that their changes are built and tested in a standardized environment. When a developer is testing a new feature locally on their machine configuration might not match the same configuration of another developer's machine. For instance, the developer's machines might not have the same version of the software framework that they're using to develop their product. And because of this, the new feature might work on one developer's machine, but not a different machine. Jenkins provides software teams a standardized build and test environment, allowing them to avoid this issue. Now that we know why we need Jenkins, let's understand where Jenkins fits into the software development process. The software development lifecycle begins with the requirements definition or planning, followed by the design of the product. We then implement the product based on the design, and once we have an implementation, we then test that implementation to ensure that it meets the requirements that were first defined at the beginning of the lifecycle. Once the product is successfully tested, we deploy it to the customer and perform maintenance or operations on it. Jenkins fits into the testing and deployment steps of the software development lifecycle. And more specifically, Jenkins helps us automate the testing and deployment of our product. Now that we know where Jenkins fits into the software development process, let's take a look at the architecture of the software development workflow with Jenkins. This sequence diagram outlines the software development workflow, and it primarily focuses on the role of Jenkins in the software development workflow. To begin the sequence, the developer writes code, and when they feel like their code is ready to be reviewed and tested, they then check that code into the source code repository, and this might be a tool like GitLab or GitHub or Bitbucket. When the developer checks in their code to the repository, this should trigger a build in Jenkins. In this diagram, I show the communication going from the source code repository to Jenkins, but this isn't always the case. Sometimes Jenkins is configured to pull the source code repository for new changes, and anytime it detects new changes in a particular repository, that will also trigger a build. But it's important to note that it's always best, if possible, to push new data to Jenkins rather than having Jenkins consistently pull the source code repository, because that might put an unnecessary load on the source code repository system. Once a build is triggered in Jenkins, Jenkins will then pull the developer's code changes down to its local workspace, where it will build and test the code automatically using the latest version of the codebase. If the automated build and test steps complete successfully, Jenkins will automatically deploy those changes to the production environment. If the build and test steps fail, the automated deployment will not happen. Regardless of whether the build passes or fails, Jenkins will still publish results to the source code repository. It's important to note that Jenkins itself is not performing the build, test, and deployment operations. It's simply facilitating the automation of these steps. For instance, in the testing step, Jenkins may trigger JUnit test cases to run automatically. And although Jenkins may not deploy changes directly to the production environment itself, it may utilize a tool like Chef or Ansible in order to update the configuration of the production servers to use the latest version of the software. Now that we have a better understanding of Jenkins architecture, we can begin with our next topic, install and configuration of Jenkins. If you'd like to learn more, be sure to follow our blog at lambdatest.com/blog, as well as our LambdaTest community at community.lambdatest.com. You can also earn resume-worthy LambdaTest Selenium certifications at lambdatest.com/certifications. See you in the next video.